Welcome to all of you. Today we will solve numerical problems on solubility in grams per liter, solubility in moles per decimeter cube or liter, and solubility product of sparingly soluble salt. Also, the problems based on conditions for precipitation. In last video, we have studied conditions of precipitation, that is when ionic product of sparingly soluble salt is greater than solubility product, then only the precipitation can take place. So based on these, we have to solve the problems. Now to solve these types of problem, these formulas we have studied in last video, that is for salt of type, simple salt of type B1A1, that means those salts in which cation anion ratio is 1:1. For such a type of a salt, KSP, that is solubility product, is equal to S square. S means solubility square, or S is equal to square root of KSP. That is the formula which we have to use in the while solving the problem. And solubility in grams per decimeter cube or grams per liter is equal to molar solubility into molar mass. This formula will give you solubility in grams per decimeter cube. And if you want to find out the solubility in moles per liter or moles per decimeter cube, then molar solubility is equal to solubility in grams per liter divided by molar mass in grams. And ionic product of a salt, when it is greater than solubility product, then precipitation can take place. And when ionic product of salt is less than KSP, then precipitation will not take place. So based on all these points, we have to solve the numerical problems. So problem number one, see how to solve the problem number one. Let us study. Problem number one is what? The solubility product of AgBr is 5.2 into 10 raised to minus 13. Calculate its solubility in mole per decimeter cube and grams per decimeter cube. You have to find out in this problem, you have to find out the solubility in moles per decimeter cube as well as grams per decimeter cube. And molar mass of the salt, that is AgBr, is equal to 187, that is 187.8 grams per mole. Now here in this problem, solubility product is given, that is KSP, value of KSP is given to you. And AgBr is a sparingly soluble salt, and KSP value of AgBr is 5.2 into 10 raised to minus 13. And also you have the, you know, the molar mass of AgBr, that is equal to 187.8 grams per mole. Now to solve this problem, what is given here? KSP of AgBr is equal to 5.2 into 10 raised to minus 13. Molar mass is also given to you, and it is 187.8 grams per mole. And the solubility equilibrium, that you have to write, solubility equilibrium of AgBr. AgBr is a sparingly soluble salt. So solubility equilibrium for this salt is AgBr solid. A very small amount of AgBr goes into the get dissolved. And the dissolved part of AgBr establishes equilibrium between the solid AgBr and dissolved Ag ions and bromide ions. So AgBr, solid AgBr gives you here Ag ions plus Br ions in a aqueous medium. So here the number of cations, that is Ag ion is 1. And number of Br ions, that is anion, is also 1. So X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 1. Now expression for solubility product for this solubility equilibria is what? Ksp is equal to molar concentration of Ag ion into molar concentration of Br ion, bromide ion. And molar concentration of Ag ion is raised to power 1 because X is equal to 1. Number of cations present in the equilibrium is 1. And therefore, concentration of Ag ion raised to power 1. And concentration of Br ion is also Y is equal to 1. So, concentration of Br ion raised to 1. Therefore, Ksp is equal to X, that is number of moles of cations X into solubility S raised to X into Y, that is number of moles of bromide ion. So Y into S, that is solubility raised to power Y, and that is equal to what? X, if you solve this, then you will get what? X raised to X into Y raised to Y into S, that is solubility raised to X plus 1. So now see here, Ksp is equal to therefore 1, number of cation, that is Ag ion, is 1, X is equal to 1, so 1 raised to 1 into 1 raised to 1, bromide ion also 1, so 1 raised to 1 into S raised to 1 plus 1, that is X plus 1, and that is equal to Ksp is equal to S square, or S is equal to square root of Ksp. Now you know the value of Ksp. Value of Ksp is given to you. So S is equal to square root of 5.2 into 10 raised to minus 30. But we cannot calculate the square root of minus 30, and therefore convert it into even number, and for that divide this 10 raised to minus 13 by 10 and multiply this 5.2 by 10, so that you will get what? S is equal to square root of 52 into 10 raised to minus 40. Therefore here the square root of 10 raised to minus 14 is 10 raised to minus 7. So 10 raised to square root of 52 into 10 raised to minus 7. You can directly calculate this, or using log also you can calculate the square root of 52. Now you can guess the your answer, that is solubility should be in between 7 to 8, because square root of 49 is 7 and square root of 64 is 8. Therefore the answer should be in between 7 to 8. So if you want to calculate it by log, then log of square root of 52 is equal to what? Half log to the base 10 of 52, and log of 52 is, log to the base 10 of 52 is 1.7160, and half of this, that is equal to 0.8580, and therefore square root of 52, this is what? The log of square root of 52 is how much? 0.8580. Therefore square root of 52 is equal to what? Anti log of 0.8580, and that comes to be 7.211. So here substitute this value, S is equal to therefore square root of 52 is equal to how much? 7.211. So 7.211 into 10 raised to minus 7, and unit of the solubility is what? Moles per decimeter cube. So here you can calculate what? Like this you can calculate solubility in moles per decimeter cube. Now in this example you have to also calculate solubility in grams per decimeter cube or grams per liter. Now if you know the solubility in moles per liter, you can calculate what? The solubility in grams per liter. And solubility in grams per liter, How you can calculate it? Solubility in grams per liter is equal to solubility in moles per decimeter cube or moles per liter into molar mass in grams per mole. And molar mass of AgBr, that is silver bromide, is given to you. So substitute this. Therefore, S is equal to molar solubility is 7.211 into 10 raised to minus 7 into molar mass of AgBr is 187.8. Therefore, this comes to be, when you solve this, then answer is how much? S is equal to 1.35 into 10 raised to minus 4 gram per decimeter cube. So thus you can calculate solubility in moles per decimeter cube or grams per decimeter cube. See the second problem. The solubility product of barium carbonate is 2.6 into 10 raised to minus 9. Calculate its solubility in mole per decimeter. In this example, you have to find out the solubility in moles per decimeter cube. So, what is given? Solubility product of barium carbonate is given. Barium carbonate is a sparingly soluble salt, and Ksp of this barium carbonate is given to you, and it is how much? Ksp of barium carbonate is equal to 2.6 into 10 raised to minus 9. So what you have to find out? Molar solubility you have to find out. So solubility equilibrium for this sparingly soluble salt, that is barium carbonate, is like this. Barium carbonate solid is in equilibrium with barium ions in aqueous medium plus CO3 minus 2 ions in a aqueous medium. And therefore, here also, it is also a same type of salt, that is having ratio 1:1, that is B1A1 type of salt. So here X is equal to 1, Y is equal to also 1. And therefore, Ksp, that is expression for solubility product for this particular salt, we can write like this. Ksp is equal to molar concentration of barium ion into molar concentration of CO3 ion. And therefore, Ksp is equal to X into S raised to X. Here, X is equal to 1 into Y into S raised to Y, where S is the solubility. X means number of moles of cation, or number of Y means number of moles of anion. Therefore, here Ksp is equal to S X raised to X into Y raised to Y into S raised to X plus Y. This is the general formula. So if you substitute here, barium, only one barium ion is there and one carbonate ion is there. So 1 raised to 1, X raised to 1 into Y raised to 1, that is 1 raised to 1 into S raised to 1 plus 1. And that is equal to what? Ksp is equal to S square. That is equal to, S is equal to square root of Ksp. Now substitute these values. S is equal to square root of, where Ksp of barium carbonate is how much? 2.6 into 10 raised to minus 9. So you cannot calculate the square root of minus 9. And therefore, multiply this 10 raised to minus, divide this 10 raised to minus 2 by 10. And 2.6, multiply the 2.6 in 6 by 10. Therefore, it becomes 26. And 10 raised to minus 9 becomes 10 raised to minus 10. And square root of 10 raised to minus 10 is equal to 10 raised to minus 5. So S is equal to square root of 26 into 10 raised to minus 5. So first calculate what? The square root of 26. And square root of 26, the by log. So log to the base 10 of square root of 26 is equal to half log to the base 10 of 26. Now log to the base 10 of 26 is equal to 1.4150, and half of this log, that is equal to 0.7075. 5. Therefore, square root of 26 log to the base 10 of 26 is 0.7075. Therefore, square root of 26 is equal to anti-log of 0.7075, and it comes to be 5.099. And therefore, the solubility of barium carbonate in mole per decimeter cube is equal to 5.099 × 10⁻⁵ mole per decimeter cube. So like this, you can calculate solubility in grams per liter as well as in moles per decimeter cube or moles per liter. Now see the third problem, that is, a solution is prepared by mixing equal volumes of 0.1 MgCl2 magnesium chloride and 0.3 molar sodium oxalate Na2C2O4 at 293 Kelvin. Would magnesium oxalate MgC2O4 precipitate out? Ksp of MgC2O4 at 293 Kelvin is 8.56 × 10⁻⁵. Here the MgC2O4, that is magnesium oxalate, is the sparingly soluble salt, and Ksp value of this salt at temperature 293 Kelvin is given to you, and it is how much? 8.56 × 10⁻⁵. And you have to find out whether the magnesium oxalate can precipitate out or not. So when magnesium chloride reacts with sodium oxalate, then what happens, that we will see. Magnesium chloride, when treated with sodium oxalate, then the magnesium oxalate is formed, which is a sparingly soluble salt, and sodium chloride is formed. Here magnesium ions from magnesium chloride reacts with oxalate ion from sodium oxalate and gives you what? Magnesium oxalate. And you know the condition, that is, ionic product of salt, when it is greater than solubility product, then solution is supersaturated and precipitation of compound will take place. And therefore, for precipitation of MgC2O4, that is magnesium oxalate, ionic product of magnesium oxalate should be greater than Ksp of magnesium oxalate, that is solubility product of magnesium oxalate. Now therefore, here Ksp of MgC2O4 is given to you, but you have to find out what? The ionic product of magnesium oxalate. And ionic product of magnesium oxalate is equal to what? Concentration of magnesium ion in the solution into concentration of oxalate ion in the solution. When it is greater than Ksp of MgC2O4, that is magnesium oxalate, then only the precipitation can take place. So Ksp of magnesium carbonate is already given to you, and that is equal to how much? 8.56 × 10⁻⁵. So this solution is prepared. In the problem, it is given that this solution is prepared by mixing equal volumes of 0.1 molar MgCl2 and 0.3 molar sodium oxalate at 293 Kelvin. That means what? When these two solutions are mixed, then volume increases, and when volume increases, then concentration of ion decreases. 0.1 molar is the initial concentration of मैग्नीशियम आयन्स इन मैग्नीशियम क्लोराइड एंड 0.3 मोलार इज द इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ ऑक्सलेट आयन इन सोडियम ऑक्सलेट. सो इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ MgCl2 इज हाउ मच 0.1 मोलार एंड इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ सोडियम ऑक्सलेट इज हाउ मच 0.3. एंड वेन द वॉल्यूम इक्वल वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ दीज टू सोल्यूशंस आर मिक्स देन वॉल्यूम गेट्स डबल एंड हेंस कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ आयन बिकम्स हाफ ऑफ द इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. देयरफॉर हियर द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ मैग्नीशियम आयन यू हैव टू फर्स्ट फाइंड आउट. सो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ मैग्नीशियम आयन इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच 0.1. बट वेन इट इज मिक्सड इक्वल वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ द मैग्नीशियम क्लोराइड एंड सोडियम ऑक्सलेट आर मिक्स देन द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन बिकम्स हाफ देयरफॉर 0.1 इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन डिवाइडेड बाय 2 एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू 0.05 मोलर. लाइक दैट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट the concentration of oxalate ion in the mixture. So concentration of oxalate ion is equal to 0.3 molar, that is the initial concentration, and initial concentration divided by 2. So 0.3 divided by 2 is that gives you 0.15. So this is what 0.15 is the concentration of oxalate ion in the solution. So ionic product in the solution is concentration of magnesium ion into concentration of oxalate ion, that is equal to 0.05 molar into 0.15 molar, and that comes to be 7.5 into 10 raised to minus 3. So ionic product of MgC2O4, that is magnesium oxalate, at 293 Kelvin, it is equal to 0.0075, that is equal to 7.5 into 10 raised to minus 3. Now Ksp value of oxalate, magnesium oxalate, is at 293 Kelvin is 8.56 into 10 raised to minus 5, and this indicates that here the ionic product of magnesium oxalate is greater than the Ksp, that is solubility product of magnesium oxalate, and here the ionic product of magnesium oxalate is 7.5 into 10 raised to minus 3, and solubility product is 8.56 into 10 raised to minus 5, and therefore ionic product of magnesium oxalate is greater than solubility product, and therefore the precipitation will take place. MgC2O4 can precipitate. So Ip is greater than Ksp, and therefore precipitation will take place. Like this you have to solve the problems. Another problem of the same type, see here, if 20 cubic centimeter of 0.50 molar barium nitrate are mixed with 20 cubic centimeter of 0.020 molar sodium fluoride, will barium fluoride precipitate? Ksp of barium fluoride at 293 Kelvin is 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 6. Now when this barium nitrate reacts with sodium fluoride, then how the reaction takes place? See here, barium nitrate reacts with sodium fluoride and gives you what? Barium fluoride, which is a sparingly soluble salt, and sodium nitrate. And this barium fluoride in aqueous medium gives barium ions and fluoride ions. Barium fluoride is a sparingly soluble salt, and when it is dissolved in water, then it gives you what? Barium ion in the aqueous medium and fluoride ions in the aqueous medium. Or these barium ions reacts with fluoride ions, two fluoride ions, and gives you barium fluoride. Now in this example, what is asked? Whether barium fluoride can precipitate out or not, that you have to find out. So you know the condition. When ionic product of salt is greater than solubility product, then only the precipitation will occur. So ionic product for the precipitation of barium fluoride, ionic product of barium fluoride should be greater than solubility product of barium fluoride. So ionic product of barium fluoride is equal to what? Concentration of barium ion in the solution into concentration of fluoride ion raised to power 2, because here 2 moles of fluoride ions are formed and therefore the power is raised to 2. 2 fluoride ions are there. So it should be greater than KSP, that is solubility product of barium fluoride. And therefore KSP of barium fluoride is given to you at 293 Kelvin. It is equal to how much? 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 6. So here the volume of 0.050 molar barium nitrate is how much? That is given in the problem, 20 cubic centimeter. And the volume of the sodium fluoride having concentration 0.020 molar is also 20 cubic centimeter. When these two solutions are mixed, then volume increases and total volume of the solution becomes how much? 40 cubic centimeter. 20 cubic centimeter of barium nitrate when mixed with 20 cubic centimeter of sodium fluoride, then total volume of the solution becomes 40 cubic centimeter. And therefore what happens? The concentration of barium nitrate in the solution will change. Initial concentration is how much? 0.050. And here also sodium fluoride concentration is what? 0.020 molar. Therefore here you have to first find out the concentration of barium nitrate. So using the formula M1V1 is equal to M2V2, that is initial molarity and initial volume. Initial volume is 20 cubic centimeter and the initial concentration of barium nitrate is how much? 0.050 molar. That is equal to the concentration, final concentration of barium nitrate when volume is 40 cubic centimeter. This is the molarity. When 20 cubic centimeter is there, molarity of the barium nitrate is 0.050. You can also calculate it directly. That is when concentration is 0.050, volume is 20 cubic centimeter, then when volume is increased by 40, then how much is the concentration? Using that also you can find out, or using this simple way, that is M1V1 is equal to M2V2. And if you substitute these values, that is molarity of barium nitrate is 0.050 into volume of barium nitrate is 20, that is equal to M2 that you have to find out, and volume, total volume of the solution is equal to 40. So 40, that is equal to what? M2 is equal to molarity in 40 cubic centimeter of solution is equal to 0.050 into 20 divided by 40, and that is equal to how much? 0.025 molar. Like that you can calculate what? The concentration of fluoride ions or sodium fluoride. So M1V1 is equal to M2V2. Initial concentration of sodium fluoride is 0.020 in when volume is 20 cubic centimeter. So you have to find out the molarity when volume is increased to 40 cubic centimeter. So M2 is equal to 0.020 into 20 divided by 40. That will give you what? The concentration of fluoride ion in the solution. So M2 is equal to 0.010 molar. So using these two here, barium nitrate, that is means barium ion concentration is 0.025 molar, and fluoride ion concentration is 0.010 molar. So Here, the ionic product of barium fluoride is equal to what? Concentration of barium ion into concentration of fluoride ion raised to power 2, because the formula of barium fluoride is BaF2. So, two fluoride ions are there. So, it is a salt of type 1:2:2 ratio. Cation anion ratio in this salt is 1:2:2. And therefore, concentration of barium ion into concentration of fluoride ion raised to 2 is equal to how much? 0.025 into 0.010 raised to 2. And that is equal to 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. And you know the ionic product. Okay, so that is solubility product of barium fluoride, and it is how much? It is given 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 6, and ionic product of barium fluoride is how much? 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 6. That means what? Ionic product is greater than solubility product, and therefore barium fluoride will precipitate from the solution. So like this, you can solve the problem based on the conditions of precipitation, as well as you can solve the problem based on the solubility in grams per liter, moles per decimeter cube, or also you can calculate what the solubility product. Thank you.